Turns out I have 6 snare drums. 7 if you include the little, what is it? I think it's like a 10-inch pearl piccolo, tiny drum that I got. But 3 of the snares are wooden, of different types, 3 different types. And then I have 3 metal drums, snare drums, that are different alloys, 3 different alloys. But this particular drum today, I want to show you. I love this little drum. It's a 12 by, I think this is 5. 12 by 5, Mapex. And they call it the warbird. And I want you to see the emblem on here if you can. It's a little dark, but I have I'll take a photo of it so you can look at it. It's really beautiful. It's basically it's an eagle. It's a two-headed eagle, actually. One side of the eagle looks like it's skeleton bones, and the other looks like just a normal kind of type of an eagle. And they're holding the arrows. Beautiful drum. This is a walnut, made out of walnut, and it's kind of a warm sounding drum, and I like that. And the other thing about Mapex, I think all of their snare drums have dual snare throws or tuning. See that? They're on both sides. And you get some really wicked, you know, snare sounds. Some really cracky, snappy kind of sounds out of the dual, which I like. And so why don't I just play it for you? I'll play it for you first, as is. I'll take the snare off. It's a small drum. Twisting one side, I tighten the tightening on the left side. And of course if I loosen it, you get more of the rattle. If you twist both, get a different type of a snap. Very nice rim shot you can get out of this drum, even though it's small. It's only 12 inches, but really good. Whap. The only drawback that I have, or the only con, would be the side stick. You're not going to get a great side stick. I've tried. And you really have to use the stick now at the very edge of the rim of the drum. Very thin, kind of a, if I move it up, that's about the meatiest that you're gonna get out of the drum. So if you're gonna side click stick, you almost gotta remember Because if you move it here, just more of a ding. Now we're getting more of the drum out of that. So that's what it sounds like in a room ambiance. And this is about a medium high tuning. In a studio setting, and what I want to do, kind of experiment, is I'm just going to add some EQ and compression to this, and then we're going to hear how that enhances and changes, not changes, yes, but enhances the drum, right? Excuse me 1 minute, while I whip this out. Towards the middle of the drum, and I just want to record this. Ooh, a little hot. Excuse me 1 second. Okay, that's better. This drum, I hope you like the way it sounds, and I'm happy with it. This drum was in the range of about, I think about 400 for this, it's well spent because I've used it. I've used it on gigs with my smaller drum set, 18-inch bass drum, and it's not very heavy. It's a small drum, it's light, warm sounding, just works well in a lot of different situations and a lot of different rooms, and I'm happy with it. And I thank Mapex for going through the trouble of making such a nice drum.